Hey y'all, coming at you with one of my absolute favorite fetch finds for fabulous hair. The lighting in my bathroom really isn't doing me justice here, but if you haven't noticed in my other videos, or if you don't know me, I have purple hair. It is something I have always wanted, since I can remember. So I finally used the global pandemic, working from home, as an opportunity to take the plunge and go purple. So that is what I did in August of last year, and I have maintained the purple up to this point. It is May now. And what I do to maintain my purple between salon visits, so I've actually only been to my amazing colorist twice, once in August of last year, once in February of this year, 2021. So what I do between visits is I use viral purple shampoo from Amazon, of course. A little water dripping down from that from the shower, don't mind that. And the viral purple conditioner. Now, I haven't done a good deep treatment with a conditioner in a while, so that's what I'm going to show you today. But real quick, just to recap, what I do with these two products regularly. So I use the shampoo in the shower. I use my color protecting shampoo from the Moroccan oil line first, and then I follow up with this, so I do like a double wash. And I use this purple shampoo. I'll leave it on for a little while I use something else in the shower before I rinse it out. And then I will mix my purple viral conditioner with the Moroccan oil conditioner or a deep conditioning conditioner if I'm doing like a special treatment or something like that. Put that on my head, let that sit before I rinse. And I try to use the coolest water that I can. I still use hotter than I probably should water whenever I'm actually like showering, but I try not to rinse my hair with anything more than like warm, cool, just to help protect my color, protect my hair. So the thing that I'm doing today, as I mentioned, is I'm going to use the conditioner and I'm going to apply it to clean, dry hair. So I washed and dried my hair, let it dry in a hair towel for a while first, and then just took the blow dryer to it for a few minutes to get it fully dry. But I'm going to apply this to my dry hair to get a really, really strong pop of purple. It's gonna really just refresh my color, make it look like it just left the salon. Now, of course, if you have naturally dark hair like me, which you can see in the roots, I did have to get my hair highlighted before the purple was applied for it to really show up. So if you have black hair, you're not just gonna be able to use viral shampoo and conditioner and have this color show up. If you have lighter hair, sure, it's probably gonna work a lot better for you. They have a lot of different colors and you won't have to necessarily go and get your hair bleached or highlighted, whatever, like I had to do before I actually went purple. So getting a little closer, you can really see it in the light. So give me just a second. I'm gonna get situated and then I'll get my camera up again so you can see what the beginning process looks like. One moment. Okay, so I went ahead and clipped up my hair. What I like to do is I do this in sections. So I've got a reasonable section that is down. I've already brushed it out, so hopefully it'll be relatively tangle-free. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some gloves because this stuff will stain. So first you can pick whatever colors you like. I obviously have purple hair, so I'm rocking the purple. You definitely are gonna want gloves though, because this will stain, even though it's arguably a semi-permanent color. If you get it on your countertop, if you get it like in your shower and you don't rinse it right away, it's gonna stain. So you're gonna wanna be really careful about that. So I, like I said, use the purple. They have tons of colors. They have pastels, they have more jewel tones. I use purple. Every now and again, I will use it. I think it's a lilac. I'll throw that in the mix just to kind of change up the purple color a little bit. But the darker purple like this is what really gives me the deep shade. So I'm gonna take a good amount of the viral purple color, rub it between my hands, my gloved hands, okay? And then I'm gonna get to work. So you're gonna wanna wear an old shirt as well, something that you won't mind if it gets the color on there. So I already got like a little spot on my arm. So I'm gonna get that really nicely saturated. Nice little squeaky sound there for you. Like I mentioned, tons of colors you can pick from. I love purple, it's my favorite color. I went to LSU, that was just a perk though, really. I've always loved purple. So the fact that that was one of my colors for college, bonus. So again, just taking this all the way nice and through, working it all through this section of hair. And I kind of like to check my gloves and see, like, is there still a good amount of product on there if it is, trying to make sure it's getting on my hair and not just sticking behind on the gloves. And then what I'm gonna do, so I'm gonna take, I have a wide-tooth wavy hair comb. I've had this thing for so long. I don't even know if they make this anymore, if they make something like it. I'm not positive, but I love this comb, especially because I actually have naturally wavy hair, so works really great for that. So I just comb that product through because I want it to be very evenly distributed. I want that purple to really, really apply. Again, you want to apply this for a deep treatment like this, like a good deep color pop. You want to apply it to dry hair, but you want it to be clean. I didn't add any products to my hair. It is just clean, dry hair. This is the product that I'm applying. So nothing else is on there. I'm gonna take a little bit more while my hair is over on this side. Make sure I'm getting that top side over here. So I'm being extra thorough. Some people may not take as much time, but if I'm gonna do one of these like deep refreshing color treatments, I like to do it this way. So I won't bore you with the details of watching me do this all the way through, but I will be doing this all the way through my hair, and then whenever it's done, I'm gonna let it sit. The bottle says at least 20 minutes. I usually let it sit longer. I just wanna make sure that purple really soaks up. Oh, and of course, for anybody who's wondering, this was recommended by my colorist. So I know there's a lot of different products that are like this on the market. She specifically recommended, hey, Beck.
We forgot my elderberry.
Oh, that's okay. We can take it in the morning. You were almost done anyway. Tell Daddy I said you can have your gummies. Close the door behind you, please.
My gummies?
Yeah, you can open up your gummies.
How many do I have?
Four. That's my five-year-old. Lost train of thought. But, anywho, so I'll be taking this all the way through all the sections of my hair. I want to make sure I get my money's worth, so I'm going to let it sit for more than 20 minutes. But that's what the bottle says, is at least 20 minutes. Oh, that's what I was saying. So there's a bunch of other products like this one on the market. This one my colorist specifically recommended, so that's what I got. She did say that there are some others that you have probably seen advertised on your social media that she doesn't necessarily recommend because she doesn't think they're as good for your hair. So just FYI, this one is approved by my colorist, not only approved, but encouraged. All right, I'm gonna finish applying this.
Why didn't you do it?
Okay, just a second. I'll be back. All right, I finished saturating my hair with my purple viral conditioner. So I'm gonna let it sit for at least 20 minutes before I rinse it out. It'll probably be closer to an hour because like I mentioned, I like to let it absorb a little longer, really, really pack more of a purple punch. I will then rinse with cool water, coolish warm water in the shower. Now, the directions on the bottle are very open-ended because whenever you do a 20-minute treatment plus like this, 20 minutes plus, it doesn't really say to do anything except rinse after. So do you rinse with shampoo? Do you follow up with some conditioner? Do you just rinse? I've done a variety of things. I don't think it makes a huge difference, but in my mind, I don't want to just, you know, shampoo it out right away. So generally what I like to do is just kind of give it a little bit of a rinse, but really massage it well. That way I'm not leaving too much residue behind, and then I'll style my hair afterwards like I normally would. So tonight, it's already actually pretty close to my bedtime. So after I rinse it out, I will probably dry it just a little so I'm not going to bed with soaking wet hair, and then actually style it tomorrow. So I will follow up with a video and some pictures once you can actually see it dry and styled. So that is it for now. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye. Here are a few before shots and some after shots so you can see the difference in the color and the vibrancy after the application of the viral conditioner. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thanks so much and bye for now.